한 아프리카 청년 포럼은 한 아프리카 재단이 외교부, 아프리카 연합과 함께 혁신적 파트너십을 위한 청년 교류라는 주제로 개최하게 되었습니다.
추운데도 불구하고 이렇게까지 와주셔서 감사합니다.
So I would like to welcome all of you to the 2019 the second Korea Africa Youth Forum. My foundation and I strongly believe that the youths are the future of the Korea and Africa, and also the future of the Korea-Africa relationship.
The Korea-Africa Foundation is doing a remarkable job in that respect and should be recognized in their efforts. This Korea-Africa Youth Forum is the ideal opportunity for young entrepreneurs to share information and knowledge with a view of strengthening cooperation and partnerships for mutual benefit.
The Korean government, noting the importance and the potential of the African continent, is pursuing its vision of building a mutually beneficial partnership with Africa. While making various efforts to cooperate and promote exchanges at the government level, we're also keen to promote people-to-people exchanges among youth, business, and culture groups, knowing its vital role in deepening our friendship.
So one of the things that we are doing as the Youth Division of the African Union Commission is to ensure that whatever Africa does or whatever partners working in Africa do speaks to unleashing the potential of young people of its young people.
(목소리) 스타트업의 한국 진출을 지원하는 그랜드 챌린지라는 프로그램이 따로 있습니다. 그래서 현재 이제 수백 개의 외국 스타트업이 한국에 들어와서 인큐베이션 받고 있는데 희한하게 아프리카에서 온 스타트업들 별로 없습니다. 제가 튀니지에서 온 스타트업 만나본 거 외에는 별로 없었는데 아마 이제 정보 전달이 잘 안 돼서 그런 것 같고요. 이번 기회에 그 아프리카 스타트업들이 한국을 거점으로 해서 아시아 시장 진출하는데 우리나라의 정부의 지원을 받는 그런 계기가 좀 됐으면 좋겠습니다.
Here are some of our numbers. We've supported over 650 startups who have gone on to raise over $79 million. We also do direct investments in these startups, and these startups have also gone on to create jobs, over 7,000 jobs.
Zipline in Rwanda as well is the world's only drone delivery system for urgent medicines such as blood and vaccine. The interesting thing about Zipline is they chose Rwanda because the Rwanda government has made a deliberate effort to ease on their policies to make sure that startups like Zipline can be able to test and launch their products. And it's doing really well, and they've been able to scale to a number of countries even outside of Africa.
We share the same vision with the African Union, which is to see how to support and create a million jobs or opportunities for young people. So for us as Sloan, we've made a commitment from 2019 to support 1,000 startups and create a million jobs over the next 5 years.
멘토링을 통한 이전 선배와의 멘토링, 기존 어떤 참업자와의 멘토링, 아니면 다른 분야에 있는 전문가하고의 멘토링, 이런 이제 시스템이 잘 되어 있고.
They had to go to 5 different accelerator programs, go through the whole process. They went to the Kenya Climate Innovation Center, they went to Growth Africa, they went to Village Capital.
So there's a lot of conversation around how we can connect the entrepreneur support organizations and put them in the universities as well.
네, 거기 굉장히 큰 시장이 있다는 것을 알게 됐고, 케냐의 지사도 설립을 하게 됐습니다. 그래서 저희가 올해에는 이제 케냐 대통령님한테 직접 이제 사업을 같이 하겠다 승인도 받고.
Pan-Africa 청년들과 함께하는 스타트업 아이디어 피치 이제 시간을 가질 텐데요. 2019년 아프리카 창업 아이디어를 통해 선발된 10개 스타트업들이 아이디어를 소개하고 그리고 최종 심사를 통해 4개 스타트업에게 창업 지원금이 이제 수여된 그런 시간을 가질 예정입니다.
3등 시상자는 스마트 디아그노시스. 공동 3등은 MGIT. 축하드립니다.
축하드립니다.
2등 시상자는 뉴트리어그리입니다.
축하드립니다.
자, 대망의 1등을 발표하겠습니다. 1등은 축하드립니다. 탭이 수상하셨습니다.
아프리카에 수인성 질병이 만연해 있어서 고생하시고 계신 분들이, 고통받고 있는 분들이 굉장히 많습니다. 그 문제 저희 TAB가 제일 앞장서서 해결할 수 있도록 최선을 다하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
한아프리카 청년 포럼이 진실로 그 한국과 아프리카를 잇는 또 하나의 플랫폼이 되도록 저희 한아프리카 재단은 열심히 하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
You know, the ideas, some were past the idea stage. You know, others had prototypes on the continent in Africa. Others had actually had feedback with regards to the products and have great potential. In fact, I will do personal follow-up on one or two of those businesses to see how they'll do as soon as they launch. This is not just a competition for ending here. Yeah. We certainly want to see these businesses launching in the continent soon.
I think the Youth Forum was great. It's interesting to see the collaborative efforts of the foundation. It was also great that it brought in different people from the different regions in Africa. It's always great to share about the interesting things that are happening on the continent.
It is through this exchange, youth exchange, towards innovative partnership in the different startups, whether it is in the health sector, the commercial setup, the creative business setup, sector, in all these areas, we need collaborative partnership. We need partnership that on both sides can be win-win. And that is why I see a future in this Korean African Youth Forum.